How do I edit a reply? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. If during this video you find it helpful and you're watching it on YouTube, hit that like button, and while you're at it, hit subscribe so you'll never miss another video posted. Here's the question I got. I've been told by a mailing list moderator that when I reply to a message sent to the list, I need to edit the reply to remove most of the original message. I don't see where or how to edit a reply. What am I supposed to do? This is not at all an uncommon request for many mailing lists, simply because, especially when there's a long discussion, all of those replies, well, they're included in your message, whether you see them or not. They can add up. They can make for very, very big and confusing messages for those people that do see them. So let's take a look at what it means to reply to a message and how you edit it. Now, I do have to point out that your mileage may vary. How you do this depends a lot on what email program or email interface you happen to be using. For this example, I'm going to be using Outlook.com. Many of the concepts that you'll see me use or talk about here apply to other email programs and interfaces as well. So you'll need to translate, if you're not using Outlook.com, to whatever email program it happens to be you're using. So, what is a reply? Well, you'd think that a reply is just a new message with the to line automatically filled in for you and the subject line automatically filled in for you. The problem is that in reality, it's much more than that. It places the original message, the message that you're replying to, into the body of your new message. Sometimes, however, it's hidden. Let's have a look. So here we are in Outlook.com, and you can see I've got an example message. I'll open it up here. Here's a message body. It's to me. There's a subject. This is an example. It's got a signature, all the good stuff. So when I hit reply, I now have what looks to be a new empty message. It's to the person that sent it, in this case, Leo at askleo.com, but it looks like it's completely empty. It's not. Notice this little ellipsis down here. If you click on that, now all of a sudden we have our reply showing you the included original message. That's all a reply is, a message pre-populated with the contents of the message you're replying to. Once you can see that, once you can expose the original message, edit to your heart's content. What does that mean? Well, I'm just going to make a couple of changes here myself. I'm going to take the from, I'm going to remove all this stuff, and I'm going to remove the signature. Now I can go back to the top and, you know, reply. Or another technique that's used frequently is instead of replying at the top, especially if you are replying to a complicated email that has a lot of salient points in it, but you want to address those points individually. First of all, many email programs will precede each line with a special character so that you know that this is the message you're replying to. And now you can say, my reply goes here. That's all it is. All we've done is we've exposed the original in our reply, and we can now edit it because it's just a part of the message that we're about to send. And yes, your moderator, your list moderator, is very, very serious about this. Like I said, if there's a lot of messages in that reply, you could delete them all. You could delete everything that's in that reply very quickly, and maybe just enough for context so that people know what it is you're replying to. Now, here's another, I'll call it a not so secret secret. And that is that, well, you can edit the reply. That means when somebody else replies to a message, technically you can't trust the original that's in their reply. For example, Here I've got my message ready to go. It says, here's a message body, please reply to this, but be sure to edit the reply. That's my original message. Okay, I can change that. There. Now it makes it look like my original message called me a jerk. Again, you're just editing what's in the message body and you can make it say anything. That's a very important aspect or a concept to understand when it comes to editing replies. Now, there are a couple of, I'll just call them potential gotchas. One is, if your email program doesn't automatically include the original in a reply, it's often a setting. You could turn it off if you like. Personally, I like to see what people are replying to within reason. I don't want to see the whole email thread, just enough so that I know what concept they're replying to. But honestly, it's up to you. Do what makes sense for you. Look for programs that are trying to be helpful, like with these ellipses that hid the original message when we composed our reply. Gmail in particular can get really confusing. There can be several different ellipses hiding different portions of the original. It gets really weird for some reason. I find it very frustrating, but it is what it is. Look for those little ellipses or whatever else your program might be doing to quote unquote help you. And like I said, this applies to email programs, email web interfaces like I'm using here. It also often applies to mobile apps that you might use for email. So be sure to check them for the option to include the original in a reply and the mechanisms that they might offer you to edit the original before you send your reply. Hope that's helpful, but that's really all it is. The concept is very, very simple. When you hit reply, the body is pre-populated with the original that you can edit once you figure out how to make it show. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/18982. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.